Hi guys, the research beginners. Though we have some excellent data generated within a short period of starting our research, many of us will have difficulty how to plot them into a figure format which is appropriate to the journals. Let us first understand, though we can represent our data in text form or table form or figure form, in the digital era, mostly the figure format is preferred because it is self-explanatory and aesthetic, catchy to the readers, even the layman can understand the research. So this is how an origin front page looks like. Here we have book 1 to edit the data. Let me edit simply some values here in my x-axis. In x-axis, simply I will take 1 to 10. I'll just extend it. And in y-axis, let me take some value, that is 500, 800, 1000. And you can extend it. So these are the data we have, x and y. Let me give x-axis as time in seconds. Then let's take y-axis to some concentration. So at present, x and y axis is ready. If this is here, we have lot of options to plot. Go to plot, you have line symbol, column bar, and three-dimensional approach also. So let us first look how to draw the line. So if our data representation in line is more explanatory and suitable, we can choose the line. Otherwise, if we have to plot it in symbol, you can choose any type of symbols, whatever you like. So this is how your data looks like. Now you can change your aesthetics of the figure. Let me say, this is how a typical origin graph looks like. So if you want to give a different color, you can opt. If you want to give a different symbol, you can do that. And if you want to increase or decrease the size of the symbol, that is also possible here. So let me see how it is possible here. If you double click, you'll get the window opened like this. So where you will get the options like symbol, wherein you have a preview, the size, and you will have its thickness. Then you'll have drop line, label, etc. So in symbol, you can adjust the symbol or you can vary the symbol however it looks like. Let me say, so like this, you can see how wonderful. I always prefer to go for this, and you can see how it looks now. This is how it looks, right? This is, if I have two or more data in y-axis, I'm going in the reverse order. So I'll have this. So right now I have almost the reverse of y-axis. So now we have one x-axis and two y-axis. The x-axis common to both y-axis. So now let us try to plot this in the symbol form. And this is how it looks. So when you have two common y-axis, when you double click here, you will have the group option wherein you can select independently or dependently your data. That is, the y-axis should be either independently worked or dependent. So when you change one, then dependent will alter all the others together. If you choose independent, then it will give, you need to change individually for each y-axis data. So let us make a group to be independent in the beginning, because that will be independent mode, and we will work on a symbol how it works. That is, I'll show this and go to 15. Then I'll choose this and go to 15. So this is how it looks. Okay guys, now we have seen how to represent the data in a good way. And then, okay guys, in this video we have seen how to make an appealing data representation, and then in the next video we will see how this x and y axis legends, the font style, size to be changed. Those all details we can see in the next video. Hope you have enjoyed this video guys. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe our channel and share it with your friends. Do comment if this is interesting, and like this video also. Thank you.